إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا ثم أما بعد My dear brothers and sisters While preparing for today's khutbah It came to my mind The frequently asked question In each and every single year Either after Ramadan or after Hajj And this question always comes for those true believers after they perform their good deeds and they came out of the details worshipping season. How I can to get to know the signs that my siyam, my fasting, and my good deed has been accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is a very common question. As a matter of fact, this question, what are the signs that my prayers, my tahajjud, my fasting of Ramadan, or when I did my hajj or my umrah, you have to have some certain signs that your good deed has been accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. First of the signs, one of the most important signs is that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, whoever gets happy about his own hasanat, about his good deed, or he or she who get upset about his sin, this is the sign of a true believer. إِذَا سَرَّتْكَ حسناتك وإذا ساءتك سيئتك فأنت مؤمن. Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم gave us the sign of whenever we came across or we practice certain good deeds in relation with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One of the major also sign after Ramadan that you have to check yourself. What did you learn after Ramadan? If you are the same Abdullah and if you are the same Maryam after Ramadan, you didn't change to a better lifestyle. You are the one who has all the defects within yourself. All of us, true believers, before Ramadan arrived, we were so much looking forward to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for istighfar as well as for tawbah. And when Ramadan arrived, the first few days, we were so much rituals in our performance, and suddenly there are people who just left over. Ramadan was a race. If you just imagine a horse race, usually when the race started, all the horses will run very fast. But who will be the winner? The one who will be reaching the end line or the last line first. So all of us, when Ramadan started, we were so much full of energy to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala properly. The first 10 days passed and there are few people who were left behind. And then another 20 days, few people were left behind. They didn't wake up and they didn't ask sincerely about tawbah or istighfar from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So my dear brothers and sisters, one of the other signs of that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepted our siyam and our good deeds during Ramadan is that we are not the same before Ramadan. When Ramadan is over a week ago, you have to ask yourself, what are the things which you used to do in Ramadan to come closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which you are still doing it? One of the good things about it is that all of us, we were so much into attending the five times prayer on time in jama'ah, because we do know that all your good deeds, all your prayers will be multiplied. Ajr will be too much during Ramadan compared to other months of the year. So you have to still to have that dream. When you were in Ramadan, how you were competing with your brothers and sisters to reach on time, to reach Takbirat al-Ihram, because you were collecting a lot of hasanat. So keep up the energy and keep up the minimum what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala needs from us. The other thing is that when Ramadan is over, fasting is not yet over. Fasting is part of our things in our religion. If we are a proper Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam nation and followers, try to have in each and every single month, choose 3 days. Either you want those white days, or you can choose Mondays or Thursdays. Because if you recall what Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, is that when he been asked why you are so much into fasting Mondays and Thursdays, he said, and he answered back, I said, because those 2 days are the days where all a'mal goes up to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I love that day, all my a'mal, when it goes up while I'm fasting. So you have to live with that concept. So we speak about siyam, we speak about salat. Let's go back again to Al-Qur'an Al-Kareem. Everybody agreed that what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Al-Qur'an Al-Kareem, Shahr Ramadan, Shahr Al-Qur'an. We know it for sure. Today is the 8th day of Shawwal. How many of us, among all of us, kids or adults, today is the 8th day? Is it the 8th chapter? Is it the 8th juz' of Al-Qur'an Al-Kareem? We were doing a lot of khatmah, a minimum of one khatmah during month. You did it, or she did it. Where are you right now? Check yourself. If you were worshipping Allah only during Ramadan, Allah is there available 365 days the whole year. So show Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that you are really going to continue to do a minimum of one khatmah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala don't ask us for more. He just need us to show him how sincere we are. Again, I have to reinforce about Al-Qur'an Al-Kareem, because without Al-Qur'an Al-Kareem, without Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's words, we are nothing. Today is the 8th day of Shawwal. All of us, if we didn't yet open Al-Qur'an Al-Kareem, my dear brothers and sisters, please try from today that Shawwal will not be over without one khatmah, because you will be going to have all the good deeds and all of hasanat. The final one is that if you are still in that dream of Ramadan, when during Ramadan you were doing a lot of sadaqat, a lot of charities to your colleagues, to your friends, to your kinships, because Silat al-Rahim is part of that sadaqah. If you were having sadaqah or zakat, the first people who are in need for it is your close relation, Don't go far and leave your close relations. Your brothers, your sisters are in need for your sadaqah, are in need for your zakat. Before I conclude, my dear brothers and sisters, for my first khutbah, think carefully about your lifestyle during Ramadan and what's happening right now for you after Ramadan. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروا إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم أجمعين. A very beautiful hadith said by Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and I thought to share it with my beloved brothers and sisters. What Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said is that something to do with when we leave this life. All of us are working very hard to keep a little bit of money in our saving accounts for one of our days, black days we call them, or our kids need them. We can have some investment and saving money or goods for us and for the future. But please, my dear brothers and sisters, try to think about the coming hadith that how Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam loved his own nation and his own ummah. All of us will leave at one point, at one moment in this life. And when we leave, while we are in our graveyard or we are in our graves, we are looking for hasanat. It's not anymore. Unless you invest while you are alive to keep something in your saving accounts, so when you're going to face Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and you, when you will be alone in your grave, those hasanat will come to you because you did something button while you are alive in this life. إِنَّ مِمَّا يَلْحَقَ الْمُؤْمِنِ مِنْ عَمَلِهِ وَحَسَنَاتِهِ بَعْدَ مَوْتِهِ. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that what are the things which can go and reach you while you are in your grave? They mentioned seven things. My dear brothers and sisters, just bear mind with me. The first thing, عِلْمًا عَلَّمَهُ وَنَشَرَهُ. A knowledge. People will say, I am not a scholar, I am not ulama, but when you share, when you spread a knowledge, especially nowadays with the social medias, with the WhatsApp, you can confirm and check about that knowledge and you can spread it in the right way. So you are participating in spreading that ilm, that knowledge. This is the first thing, because if you spread a word speaks about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and showing the people the right direction, how to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and those people who are going to follow your way of knowledge, when you pass away, you will find that hasanat with you, giving you the blessed time while you are in your grave. أَوَّلَدٌ صَالِحٌ تَرَكَ. This is what Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, إِذَا مَاتَ ابْنَ آدَمَ انْقَطَعَ عَمَلُهُ إِلَّا مِنْ ثَلَاثٍ. And he mentioned very clearly, وَلَدْ صَالِحٍ, a son or a girl whom you raise them in the right way. And this is what I really sense it and I really appreciate from your community, that each and every single weekend you look after the kids, because those kids, they will be the investment for us. Because when we leave this life, those kids, if you teach them right how to pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, each and every single action they will do it, they will pray for you, they will do dua for you, as well as all their prayers goes back to you in your grave. Number three, أو مصحفاً ورثة. How many times there are, by the way, rural areas around the globe, they are looking forward to have a mushaf. In fact, there are people in villages, they are sharing one mushaf among hundreds or even thousands of people. So a mushaf warratha, whenever you have the time, and there are so many charities in Kuwait societies, they are helping you to spread and to take little bit of amount of money to spread al-mushaf al-kareem for certain areas around the globe. Aw mushafan warratha. Whoever we're going to read from that mushaf, each and every single letter, he or she will be getting that hasanat, as well as you who left behind you a mushaf for those people who are not able to read mushaf because they don't have the money enough to buy it. أو مسجداً بناه. While you are alive, there are a lot of people, either in your country, in your communities, are looking for to build a masjid. It's not necessarily you have to build a masjid solo by yourself. Sharing, building a small masjid to let people to do their prayers is one of those things which Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us. Among those seven things which going to be the investment for you while you are in your grave. أو بيتاً لابن السبيل بناه. Or house, a shelter. A year ago, there is a charity in Kuwait. We discovered that charity, they built around 12 small houses in one of those countries, Kyrgyzstan, and for those widowed whom they were looking after their kids. 12 houses, small ones, it didn't cost much, but they were able to keep those widowed, Muslim widowed, inside those small houses. If we consider those small houses, it was only two bedrooms with two toilets and a living room. So it was so much for this widow lady with her kids to live in that house. So this is one of those investments. أو نهراً أجراه. Giving money to help people to have wells, bi'r. This is one of the things which comes to you in your grave. This is the thing which calls current. أو صدقة أخرجها من ماله. A charity. Be careful, my dear brothers and sisters. This is the last thing. أو صدقة أخرجها من ماله في صحته وحياته. This is the condition. Don't give sadaqah while you are sick. Of course, da'u marbakum wa sadaqah. But try to give charity. Give sadaqah while you are alive and you are in your healthy condition. You are not sick. And don't consider and don't suspect that people after you leave this life will do sadaqah for you. Fine, but you never know how things can go off. For example, if you leave, let's say 100, your people who are going to get the legacy after you pass away from this life, if you were alive, you would have give, let's say 50, but when you pass away, they may give 10. So try to build your own legacy now, before you will be alone in your grave, and that time, unless you left those seven things I told you about, otherwise you are the loser. اللهم عز الإسلام والمسلمين وأذل الشرك والمشركين ودمر اللهم أعداء الدين اللهم انصر من نصر هذا الدين واخذل من خذل هذا الدين اللهم عز الإسلام والمسلمين وأذل الشرك والمشركين ودمر اللهم أعداء الدين اللهم انصر إخواننا المجاهدين في كل مكان اللهم انصرهم على عدوهم وعدوك يا رب العالمين اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات إنك سميع مجيب للدعوات وأقم الصلاة. Yeah.